Welcome to Detroit Sports Jersey Media, Sundays from 11 a.m. to noon, broadcasting live from Detroit and stretching to Texas and the Virgin Islands, here on 107.3 FM WVIE, with co-host Longhorn. Straight sports talk, no professionals here, and now here's your host that never gets it right, but is never wrong, Will.
All right, welcome to Detroit Sports Jersey. I'm your host, Will, with the Longhorn. What's happening, Longhorn?
What's up, what's up? Game time, prime time, Detroit Sports Jersey media time. Let's get it on, popcorn.
All right, let me throw out the number, 313-868-0331. Before we get into some hot sports topic, the Longhorn has some public announcements that he would like to make. Not me, but him.
All right. You know, we always talking about sports and how important sports is, right? But you always got to have something to fall back on. You got to have something to fall back on, and that's education. So I would like to announce that the mayor of Detroit, old Duggan himself, had made an announcement Tuesday that there's an initiative called the Detroit. I'm gonna read it, make sure I get it right. The Detroit Promise Zone Scholarship, right? And what it is if a student graduates from a Detroit public high school or private or charter, as long as they graduate, and if they've got to live in Detroit, and they last 2 years now have to be spent at a public, private, or chartered high school in Detroit, They apply for the Pell Grant, then the Detroit Promise Zone Scholarship will cover the rest of their tuition to a two-year community college. Now, that's fantastic.
That's a good thing for the city of Detroit and for the students of Detroit here in the great metropolitan area right here in the hot D.
Because what that's giving you now is no excuse that saying that you cannot afford to go to at least a two-year college. You know what I'm saying? And students must apply for the Pell Grant, right? And there's five community colleges that they could go to. And for more information, all they have to do is go online, and this is all one word, DetroitScholarshipFund.org. DetroitScholarshipFund.org for more information. And go on that website, check it out, get your butts in school, get your money,
and please,
go to school, get your education, and then worry about playing ball.
Please, parents and kids, take advantage of this situation. Don't be like my dumb ass kids don't get me wrong. You know, they were smart, intelligent, graduated high school, but, you know, they're getting their stuff together now after years of being out of high school and learning the hard way. But, you know, like my youngest daughter, for instance, let me use her as an example. Who wouldn't want to graduate when you're 16 years old? Well, she had that. I mean, she graduated at 17, but she had a chance to graduate at 16. And then, you know, could have had a few years of college semesters under her belt. But no, she wanted to stay with her class. Man, damn them.
Wow, stay with her class.
Man, damn them. I'm out of here. You know, for real, man. I was really mad and pissed off about that, you know. But it is what it is. And then let me tell you about my oldest daughter. Let's touch bases on her real fast.
You put them on.
Oh, hell yeah. That's what I'm trying to tell these kids. Now, take advantage of this right now. Don't be like my kids when they was younger, they dumbasses. But they, you know, together now. 4-year scholarship at Western Michigan. I'm tell you what happened with her, right, real briefly.
How you really feel.
When everything was paid for along, I'm talking about, all she had to do was get up out of bed and just go to class. Food was paid for. Books, dormitory, everything, class, she gonna cut me out. And daddy, they kicked me out of school because you make too much money. Get the hell out of here with that. Who get kicked out of school because their parents make too much money? So, of course, I done my investigation, kind of found out she wasn't going to class. But make a long story short, she going to tell me, to my son, you know, she got kicked out. She got a job at Walmart. She going to come running home to me one day. Daddy, they yelling at me up there. I said, well, if you're the... I said, well, if you'd have kept your black ass in school, you could have been the one doing the yelling. You know what I'm saying? But what the hell you want me to do? Cause I'm not about to go up there and go to jail because they're yelling at you. You know, the hell out of here with that. But anyways, you know, fortunately, she woke up, got her stuff together. She's a drug counselor now, where she, you know, counseling people that's on drugs and alcohol, which is a good thing, you know, but... These kids today, take advantage of this situation. Go out there and get that scholarship. 2 years paid for. What's that website again, Longhorn?
That website is DetroitScholarshipFund.org. DetroitScholarshipFund.org. Parents, students, go ahead and Google that website. Get the information.
Man, for real.
So that your 2-year scholarship is also paid for trade schools and community college. There are 5 community colleges that they were paid for. Hey, get your education on. I'm trying to tell you, without a degree out here, your chances of a higher income
and let me
could
say,
be slim.
Let me say this to
I'm trying to tell you.
Let me say this to the parents also. Don't put no pressure on your kids, because everybody wasn't meant for college. You know what I'm saying? Everybody wasn't meant to go.
They pay for trades.
Yes, what I'm
also.
Saying. And there's nothing wrong with having a trade and going to trades. That's what I'm about to say. Don't put no pressure, you know, on your kid. Because I'm telling you right now, hell no, I wasn't college material. Hell, I was glad to get out of high school. See, and that was with pressure, because I didn't want to get no whooping.
Yeah, hey, believe me, y'all. As his brother, I can tell you.
That was pressure right there. It wasn't because I wanted to, you know, graduate it. I didn't have no choice. Either that or get beat down.
I can co-sign for that one, y'all. I can co-sign for that.
But, you know, don't put no pressure on your kids out there. By the way, let me say this, too. Happy Easter to everybody out there also, you know. Everybody go out there and have fun. Unlike the Longhorn, he don't believe in no holidays. He don't believe in no holidays. You know, I asked him earlier, what you doing for Easter?
Hey,
what is Easter? What that mean? Damn, Longhorn.
I know what Easter means, but Easter does not mean to me going out here and barbecuing, you know, and all that type
you can tell
shenanigans.
You can tell the Longhorn.
I know Easter mean to you, putting on your new Easter outfit.
You can tell the Longhorn Merry Christmas. You can tell the Longhorn Merry Christmas. Damn, Santa Claus. I didn't see him when I... Yeah, Longhorn, I mean, no holidays. Happy Thanksgiving. Damn that turkey. Yeah, Longhorn, happy Halloween. I ain't getting no candy. The hell you talking about? Yeah, somebody snatched his bag 40 years ago. He still, you know, he just happy 4th of July, Longhorn. I don't eat no pork.
What?
I mean, just no holiday is good for that man. None. Well, you know, Longhorn, what about Memorial Day? What I tell you, I don't eat no pork, you know. But
man,
anyway, happy Easter, everybody out there.
I'm a veteran, so.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I appreciate that holiday.
Oh, Veterans Day.
Every
your day
is a holiday for me.
Oh, that's good. It's your last year in the military, ain't it, Longhorn?
That's right. I retired this year.
You're going out with Obama.
You're going out with Obama, ain't you? That's right. 20 years. He will be the one signing my retirement paper. That's right.
So you don't want Trump or Hillary to sign it? Huh, Longhorn? He got quiet. Longhorn, you got quiet? You can't hear me now? Uh-oh, what done happened? When I lost Longhorn? You still there, Longhorn? Yeah, he froze up. Yeah, he done froze up on us. Longhorn called back, but anyway... Yeah, he don't. There he goes. He's moving. No, he done froze up on us over there. You got to hit us back up, Longhorn. But check this out. We're going to talk some NBA today. You know, the Pistons. two games ahead of Chicago in the eighth place for the playoffs. Of course, they lost to Atlanta last night, stopping a five-game winning streak. We're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the NCAA tournament. You know, they're getting down to the Final Four after today. So far, we have Oklahoma and Villanova in there today. So we're going to touch bases on that. Also, we want to discuss RG3 going to the Cleveland Browns. Is that a good fit for him or not? Also, we're going to discuss the Rockets GM talking about he would love to do away with the NBA Finals and have the Final Four elimination process going on. So if you want to join in on the conversation at 313-868-0331, feel free to chime in. Also, we have Jerry Jones explaining about why the Cowboys are still interested in Johnny Manziel. And, of course, LeBron discussing he wants to put the dream team together with LeBron, Carmelo Anthony, Dwayne Wade, and Chris Paul. So we're going to take a quick commercial break. When we come back, all these topics will be on the table. 313-868-0331. Also, the Jersey Girl is supposed to be joining us shortly. Also, hopefully, we'll be back after a word from our sponsor.
Detroit Sports Jersey Media is the hottest sports radio show in Detroit and beyond. We stretch to the Virgin Islands and the heart of Texas. For advertising information, email info@DetroitSportsJerseyMedia.com or call 313-624-7814. We air live every Sunday at 11 a.m. Eastern Time on 107.3 FM WVIE. Detroit Sports Jersey Media is sponsored by ENO Productions. Are you looking to create a professional slideshow or video for business or a special celebration? Then go to fiverr.com/ENO Productions for top quality video production work. Orders are done to your taste and specifications. ENO Productions is the team that everyone goes to when they want their videos done right. That's ENO Productions. Go to fiverr.com/ENO Productions. That's fiverr.com/ENO Productions. Detroit Sports Jersey Media is sponsored by Sandra De La Cruz. Sandra De La Cruz is an independent beauty consultant for Mary Kay Cosmetics. She is based out of Killeen, Texas. To reach her, her phone number is 254-681-2456, or you can shoot an email to sdelacruz, that's sdelacruz, sdelacruz622 at marykay.com. She is enriching women's lives with Mary Kay.
All right, welcome back to Detroit Sports Jersey. I'm your host, Will Longhorn. What's going on, Longhorn? Seems we got you back in the house. Here's ours.
What's up? What's up, y'all? I'm back. I'm back.
All right.
Talk
all
about
right.
That retirement, man. I think Skype just retired on me early.
Yeah, we was wondering what was going on, Longhorn. You got some more public announcements about some high schools jumping off here in Detroit before we jump off into the NBA and NCAA.
Yes, yes. You know, you and I, we play chess, so I'd like to give a good shout out good luck to the high school chess team up there. They go into the ATL to play in the High School Chess Federation National Championship. And they're led by retired math teacher Malcolm Lewis. That's from ninth graders up to 12th graders. I'm going to give a shout out to those guys. And there are two girls on the team. So shout out to those players. Wish them all the luck in the world going down there to play some chess. You know, that's a thinking game right there. So good luck to them. Also, Detroit, Henry Ford took the Class B state championship. Shout out to Detroit, Henry Ford. Great job, fellas, in basketball. And for the third time, Detroit Jesuit High School has taken for the third straight time the regional title. Shout out to them. You guys up there doing, making it do what it do. All right, that's my public announcement and my high school, what's going on in the high school arena and sports. Great job, you guys. Hey, we got to get get Malcolm Lewis on the show because, you know, I love playing some chess. I get down on the board, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's been a while since I played chess, but you one thing you're
right.
Yeah,
that's what they all say when they get ready to lose. It's been a while since I played chess.
Well, I ain't even played, even use that excuse, Longhorn. It's been a while. Hell, let me play first before I use that excuse, you know. But, yeah, you're right about one thing. Chess is a thinking game, and it keeps your mind sharp, you know. Unfortunately, in my circle, I don't have that many people that play chess, you know, which is a shame, which is meaning telling me, hell, maybe I need to change my circle. You know, that's what I'm getting out of it. You know, cause you know the old saying goes, if you're the smartest one in your circle, you need to change your circle.
Hey, you can play online. There's chess clubs in Detroit.
I know, you know, man, but... Man, I'm so busy, man. I'm just busy with work, man, unfortunately. You know, when you're working 80 hours a week, brother, it's hard. It's really, well, 79 hours. But who's counting? You know, it is. It is what it is. But anyway, Longhorn, speaking of working hard, let's jump off into these Detroit Pistons. You know, they're two games ahead of Chicago in the eighth and final spot for the playoffs. One game behind Indiana. I think they lost against Atlanta last night. You know, Atlanta stopping their five-game winning streak. Sweet. But actually, if I was the Pistons, I think you might want to try a little harder so you can get out of that eighth spot, because I don't think you want to face Cleveland in the first round of the playoffs. I think you'll have a better chance with Toronto than you will Cleveland. Longhorn, what's your thought?
I think you're right about that. But if you think about it, Cleveland's only one person deep, and that's James. That's why I look at it. There's only one person deep. Pistons,
you really
if they
can't
shut them
say
down,
that, Longhorn. They got Kyrie Irving and Kevin Love. Now I know.
Oh, Lord, not to get Love and Irving. You know, they're iffy.
Longhorn, they're not one man deep. I have to totally disagree. I mean, we can agree to disagree, but I think that they, you know, I don't think the Pistons really want to meet them in the first round playoff. Then again, saying that, when you're a team, just like other teams in the NCAA, you know, one and done bracket, when you don't have nothing to lose, you can come out there and shock a lot of teams. Ask Michigan State what happened to them against Middle Tennessee State. They got shocked. They had nothing to lose. Y'all didn't expect us to go nowhere. You know, I mean, even if Middle Tennessee State didn't go no further, which they didn't, that was a big victory for that school, something to build off of.
A good recruiting build. That's a good recruiting advertisement right there.
So the same thing with the Pistons. If they go out there and shock Cleveland in the first round, is something to build off of. But I still believe that you should play a little harder to try to get that seventh spot from Indiana so you can face Toronto. As it stands right now, the Detroit Pistons, let me go to the glass. The Detroit Pistons, of course, will be facing Atlanta.
That's your glass.
You know, Toronto.
You said let me go to the glass. Yes. Your glasses. That's the glass.
Toronto will be placed Indiana. Atlanta will be facing Charlotte and Boston and Miami.
You know what? Pistons' best offense is their defense. So if they come out with a strong clamp down defense, tenacious defense against the Cavaliers, then the only person on the Cavaliers that can do any damage is LeBron.
No, Longhorn, because let me put it to you like this. Okay.
I'm trying to tell you.
You know LeBron going to get his, right?
That's what I'm saying.
So you can't So you can't go in with the focus of shutting him down. You have to go in with the focus of shutting the other two down.
That's what I'm saying.
Kyrie Irving and Kevin Love
are on all cylinders on their defense. When the Pistons cylinders are all on defense.
I mean, hell, Longhorn, we can say that about offense. Longhorn, we can say that about every team in the NBA. When they clicking, they clicking. Hell, ain't nobody. It's not like ain't no team won no games this year. Hell, we can say that about Philadelphia, who hell sitting at nine, only done won nine game, 9-64. Hell, out of them nine games, I'm quite sure they was clicking. You know.
But so, you know defense, you know Pistons, their defense is what brought them this far. You got to be for real. You got to keep it real. Their defense brought them.
Well, hold on, Longhorn. They played. Was it Charlotte the other night? And they scored 72 in the first half. So you can't really say that.
72 in the first half. That's the most they ever. Charlotte's defense. Are you serious?
You know. So I'm just saying. You know.
Charlotte's defense. Come on, brother. You might as well go back and look at an All-Star game. With 100-something points to 173 to 194, it's about the same thing.
But see, Pistons also said. The Pistons also said that they was disappointed in giving up. I think like 54 points, 52, 56, something like that. So that means that their defense wasn't really all of that. It was about the offense. So they got a combination of both, Longhorn, for real. Like you said, it's all about clicking at the same. See, both got to click at the same time with the Pistons. You can't have one or the other because it's not going to work. Both of them got to go hand in hand with each other with this team in order to make it far and deep into the playoffs. It's as simple as that. I don't know if you done checked out some of their games this year or not, but when both are clicking, dog, they basically unstoppable. If you got one showing up for the defense and there's no offense, they lose. Same vice versa. When there's offense and no defense, they lose. Both of them be clicking at the same time. 313-868-0331. 313-866-0331 if you want to chime in with the conversation. But let me ask you a question, Longhorn. Speaking of NBA, the Houston Rockets general manager. Let me get your thoughts on this. He want to do away with the NBA playoffs and do the one and done. Like the college basketball format. What's your thought on that? One and done. It's plain and simple.
Totally agree. Totally agree. You one and done, you out of here. Totally agree.
Well, let me tell you why that would never work in the NBA.
I know why it never worked.
Money.
Money. It's all about the M-O-N-E-Y. That's why it never worked. You talking about losing TV contracts. You talking about losing commercials. You talking about losing commercials, TV contracts, contracts with the players and the owners on points putting up, reboundings, endorsement deals. That's a whole lot of money going down the tube. Well, and you talking about a shorter NBA season.
Well, let's put it like this.
It's all about the MO anyway.
I don't think it's so much the TV contract, Longhorn. What I will say is the revenue in the stadium. I'm give you a perfect example, right? Let me give you a perfect example. I'm just going to use this as an example. I know they're in different conferences or whatever, but let me just use. Right. But if I go with the same conference, let's go with the same conference. If you have a one and done. Uh-huh. With the Pistons and the New York Knicks, how many people you think is gonna feel that? How many people you think really gonna feel the stands in that game? If you got, you know, the Knicks and the Pistons doing a one and done, I don't think there's gonna be a sellout. Now let's say you have
a sellout.
Let's say you have a Cleveland. No, there's gonna be no sellout. There ain't nobody gonna see that. I use my original scenario. Let's say the Knicks. And Sacramento, like I know they're in different division, different conference. Ain't no, that's just gonna be no sellout, Longhorn. They both sorry, and that's not gonna be no sellout. Let's say you doing Cleveland and Golden State. Once again, I know there's different conferences or whatever, but there's gonna be sellout on that. That's what I'm saying. Where you go with an opportunity, the TV contract money is already there, Longhorn. It's already there. They can't take that away. The contracts are already signed and guaranteed. But I think the money loss is going to be, like I said, with the ticket sales of filling the stands with the fans and selling them damn $20 hot dogs a piece. That's where the money's going to be lost at one and done, as compared as you can get these fools to come there 3-4 games, you know, depends on who got the home court advantage, you know, right. But you know what I'm saying? But that's where the money's going to be lost at. So that's why I don't think this ideal is going to work. Now, it's a good ideal in your head, but on paper, financially, it'll never happen. Never. Why you think they expanded the NBA playoffs? Remember they used to do the three? It used to be three rounds.
But see, this
used to be
saying.
Five rounds, not seven.
What I'm saying is, it has something to do with the TV contracts, because the TV contracts are like years out. You understand what I'm saying?
But that money's already there.
So if they were to say one and done, they would have to renegotiate those contracts. And a whole lot of money will
no,
be
no,
lost.
No, 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 man. We don't have to renegotiate nothing, because a contract is a contract. Now,
they
when the contract is up,
they have one and done. Not, those okay. contracts are for, like you say, for series. So if they come out and say we're going to do a one and done, if you don't think the networks and the cable station would be suing the NBA. Oh, you got another thing.
Oh, yeah, Longhorn, of course, if they change it in mid, you know, stride of the contract, of course. But I'm just saying, let's say, you know, they started off, you know, we don't have no contract with the TVs. You know what I'm saying? I don't think it's going to work. You know, I mean, the NBA, the TV's going to, I'm going to tell you something right now. The TV ain't going to back away from that, because that's money they're going to make off of commercials. You know what I'm saying? So they're not going to do that. They're not going to run away from the NBA because they're doing one and done. It
no,
might
not
be
away,
as it's not might be as much money. They're
as
not going
as much money. It was
no.
Brother.
No.
Do you,
go ahead. What you got to say, Longhorn?
Do you think it might not be as much money? Do you think they're gonna make more money? No, it won't be as much money. One and done, it's a wrap.
All right, well, you know, I don't think it's going to, you know, work out financially. That's all I'm saying.
It won't work out financially.
All right, let's switch subjects right here. We agree and agree on that.
We agree to disagree, but yeah. I would support one and done.
I kind of would, too, to be honest with you. But you talking about – But he said the NBA finals. So, basically
– the finals, yeah, one and done.
And
let's
the finals.
Wrap it up, move on to the next – you know, go ahead and get the championship – team up in there, and let's wrap it up.
I would do it with the playoffs. I wouldn't do it with the finals. I wouldn't do it with the finals.
You do it with the playoffs.
I do it with the playoffs. Yeah, I wouldn't do it with the finals. That's, you know.
So you let the finals go the whole seven series?
Most definitely. Well, if it goes that far, depends on who playing. It didn't go that far last year. When Golden State.
How about okay? Let's compromise here. How about a three game up to the finals, and the finals a five game? Let's go that route.
We possibly can go there. All right, Longhorn, we're gonna take a quick commercial break. We're gonna do just a little bit more NBA talk, then we're gonna switch over to some NFL. I just want to touch basically on this Golden State record. And I want to
Golden State, baby. Let's talk about this.
And I want to talk about LeBron James. Once again, that's LeBron James in the news. Every week there's news talking about putting this dream team together. He'll take a pay cut. We're talking about that. We're going to take a quick commercial break. We'll be back after a word from my sponsor.
Detroit Sports Jersey Media is the hottest sports radio show in Detroit and beyond. We stretch to the Virgin Islands and the heart of Texas. For advertising information, email info@DetroitSportsJerseyMedia.com or call 313-624-7814. We air live every Sunday at 11 a.m. Eastern Time on 107.3 FM WVIE. Detroit Sports Jersey Media is sponsored by ENO Productions. Are you looking to create a professional slideshow or video for business or a special celebration? Then go to fiverr.com/ENO Productions for top quality video production work. Orders are done to your taste and specifications. ENO Productions is the team that everyone goes to when they want their videos done right. That's ENO Productions. Go to fiverr.com/ENO Productions. That's fiverr.com/ENO Productions. Detroit Sports Jersey Media is sponsored by Sandra De La Cruz. Sandra De La Cruz is an independent beauty consultant for Mary Kay Cosmetics. She is based out of Killeen, Texas. To reach her, her phone number is 254-681-2456, or you can shoot an email to sdelacruz, that's sdelacruz, sdelacruz622@marykay.com. She is enriching women's lives with Mary Kay.
All right, welcome back to Detroit Sports Jersey Media. Check us out at Facebook at Detroit Sports Jersey Media. Go like our page, nothing but hot sports topic on there. Ain't none of that old porno and you know what I ate for dinner and all what we had for lunch and my boo went and got me a bagel type thing. You know, don't nobody care about it. Oh, by the way, people out there that's going to post stuff on social media with their Easter dinner. Don't do that. We all eating the same thing. We all eating the same thing, you know. So what you got to
have? I'm eating hamburgers.
What you got to have? Oh, that's right. The Grinch. The stove.
I'm eating hamburgers and french fries. I'm telling you right now what I'm eating.
The Grinch that stole Easter. He don't believe in no Easter eggs or the bunny. So you.
Hey. What is Easter eggs is besides scrambling eggs for breakfast?
We forgot
got
about
to do with Easter.
I forgot
That's
about.
What I want to know.
I forgot about people out there. He don't do that, you know. You know he.
That's
don't
what inquiring minds want
to
know.
He don't believe in going to church, showing off his once a year, you know, suit getting, strutting, limousine, jet setting, gator shoe wearing, Rolex watch, time keeping. How many people going there? How many people you know Longhorn going to church today for the first time out of the year? How many you know?
How many people I know?
Yeah, that's going to church today.
For the I first... don't know.
Oh, that's right. I forgot the Grinch. He don't even just. What'd you say? What'd you say?
How many people do you know that's going to church? Did you go to church this morning?
No. I know some people, though. Oh, yeah. In the family, too.
Yeah.
Speaking of church, right? Getting back to my younger daughter, I asked her last week, I said, you going to church next week, next Sunday, which will be today, right?
Right.
And she said, yeah. I said, there you go. So then I asked, I said, what about that church I used to drop you off at or pick you up at every Sunday? You still go there? Nah, that's too much drama there. Man, what kind of church you go to where that drama? What kind of church is it with drama? You know what? I was like, oh, man, that was
I thought you go to hear the word. I know you go for drama.
Exactly. What drama? What kind of church you at where there's just drama? You know? Just... But anyway, Longhorn.
Hey, that's that church of Lottie Love, ain't it?
Check this out, Longhorn. A couple of more things in the NBA. And we're going to We're going to leave us alone.
Golden State, baby.
Let's talk about them. Okay, check this out. Golden State, you know, they play today. Let me get this up right quick.
They're seven wins away from the record.
You know what I'm saying? They 65-7. They have to go 8-2 in their last 10 games. Seven of those games are at home, which I see them winning them all with the teams that they playing: Philadelphia, Washington, Boston, Portland, Minnesota. They got San Antonio, and Memphis at home. Now they three road games. Yeah, they play San Antonio twice. Matter of fact, 3 days apart. They play them on the 7th, April the 7th, and April the 10th. But
San Antonio had his car.
Okay, now they whooped San Antonio ass early too this year in San Antonio. So I hope people don't forget that now.
San Antonio clapped down on them though.
Man, okay, that's all good. But don't act like San Antonio owned them.
I didn't say they owned them. I just said they clamped down on them.
But they got Utah, Memphis, and San Antonio on the road. Now, all they have to do is steal one of those games on the road to get this record. But let me tell you something about this record, what people fail to realize. I'm going to tell you what's going to happen with this, right? I'm going to tell you exactly what, because you got so many Golden State haters out there, like it was last year. Yours truly, Charles Barkley, was number one in it.
Saying the
shooting team will never win an NBA championship. Okay, shooting team, one championship, Charles Barkley, zero, which they had a T-shirt made up of that. But I'm going to tell you where the pressure is going to come on them now. They get the record, right?
Right.
You know what the pressure is going to come on them now? Now they got to win a title because you know what? The Bulls won a title with their record. That's going to be the pressure that they put on. If they don't win the record, then, of course, you know, the haters got something to, you know, sink their teeth into. And this is bottom line. That's what the haters do out here.
They're going to say the record was nothing.
Yeah, exactly. Same thing that happens when New England went undefeated that year and they didn't win the Super Bowl. You know, they were talking all that garbage about New England getting the record or tying them with Miami. But, of course, the Dolphins won the Super Bowl that year. Was it 72, something like that year, whatever the year it was. But, of course, all the haters came out, had their teeth, something to, you know, clamp down into. It meant nothing because they didn't win the title. So this is the same thing that's going to go on with Golden State. If they don't win the title, which barring any major injuries, I see them win. I don't see no team beating them in no seven-game series, not even the Spurs. Not even the Spurs. I don't see nobody beating them in those. Especially if they get home court advantage throughout the playoffs. I don't see nobody beating them. It's plain and simple. Your thoughts, Longhorn?
Well, you think about it. I say I'm going with Golden State all the way, brother. All the way to the clickety clock of 0-0 and the of the buzzer at the end of the series. And I got a couple of records I want to put out here. Number one, they've just hit Friday a record of 938 three-pointers. They hit 21 three-pointers against the Mavs on Friday. 21. And Barkley talking about a shooting team could never win the championship. 21? Are you serious? Also, they're the fastest team to win 60 games. In the NBA. And also, they got 52 straight wins at home. Now, those are some records that are just, like, phenomenal. You know what I'm saying? Unbelievable. So, I'm going with Golden State Warriors all the way to the clickety-clack-clack of 0-0 and the buzzer at the end of the championship. So, but there was this one guy who wrote an article in the Rolling Stone. That was pretty funny to me. They said that old Curry was ruining his fourth grade basketball team because you know how people like to say they want to be like Mike? Well, players on his team said they want to be like Curry. So instead of them coming down across half court and throwing it to the open player underneath the basketball, underneath the rim, they was coming down as soon as they crossed half court saying it's Curry time and just throwing Hail Mary three-pointers and not even hitting the rim or the backboard. And that reminded me of you when we was playing basketball at the 4-H. And you threw that hook shot at the half-court line.
I was just trying to piss people off.
You remember you threw that hook shot at the half-court line in 4-H and on that team we played for? And that was way before Curry. I think Curry wasn't even born then, boy. Fan, listening audience, if y'all should have saw Will throwing that hook shot at the half court line, y'all have been rolling. But anyway, he said that Curry is ruining his the way he's trying to teach his fourth graders. It's a very funny article in the Rolling Stones magazine.
You know what I think about that article, Longhorn? He's a sorry coach, and he's trying to use any excuse of why his team sucks. At fourth grade, exactly. See, I don't even know that, and I call. You say fourth grade, four years. What's the thing again?
Fourth grade.
Get the hell out of here! Don't quit trying to use your pathetic coaching on Curry. You know, if they run it down there,
it's Curry time.
And then every time somebody screams that, he need to pull him out and bench him. Why he keep him in the game? Because he's a sorry coach. Now, if they would be making them shots and winning games, he wouldn't say a word. Obviously, they throwing up air balls, not making them, and they're losing. Like you said, they haven't won a game yet. Don't put that on Curry. Anyway, let's move on from that garbage. That sucks. But check this out. Your quick thoughts about LeBron, Carmelo, Dwayne Wade, and Chris Paul putting the dream team together. Every player, well, let me say Carmelo and LeBron said they will take a pay cut to make this happen. What's your thought on that?
It's not going to happen.
Now, they didn't say what team they would, you know, play for, try to pull this off as. But they, which I'm assuming, to be honest with you, if I was to have to take my pick, I would say they have to go, they go to Miami. If I'm telling you the reason why, I don't see Dwayne Wade. He got championships. He has nothing to prove. He don't have no reason to leave Miami. You know, the fans are getting on LeBron's nerves. He done unfollowed all the Cleveland Cavaliers fans on Twitter or Instagram, one of those. He done unfollowed all of. Why would you go to New York in that misery, you know? Right. So the only place I can see all of them coming to, basically, is Miami. I think Dwayne Wade is faithful to Miami. Miami's been good to Wade, so why would I want to leave? I have no reason to leave. I got three championships. I have no reason to leave, you know.
But it'll never happen. Just because you put those players on a team doesn't mean that's a dream team to the road to the NBA championship. It's just a team of players of wishful thinking. That's all that is. Now, if you're talking about, you know, with the Olympics coming up, you know, they already got great players that's going to represent the United States in the Olympics that's going to be quote unquote the dream team to get us a gold medal. That's cool. But a dream team, you talking about putting these players, it's not like pick up basketball where you can stack the deck and go to your local playground and say, oh man, here come those guys. You know they're gonna be on the court all day. So there's no need to call it Nets because they're gonna be out there all day. So it's never gonna happen. I don't care what type of pay cut he's talking about getting and playing wherever, but it's not going to happen. So that's just a wishful thinking for publicity stunt. So, no, it's not going to happen.
All right, Longhorn.
Two thumbs down.
Give me some of that. I agree with you, man. It's all, even if it happened, man, it's all garbage to me. Why you got to stack the deck to win championships? You know, they never done that back in the day with the Magic and the Birds. They never stacked the deck. You know what I'm saying? They never stacked the deck.
Yeah, so it won't
so
happen.
You're tarnishing your career to me if that was to happen for real.
He's a ring chaser now. He's trying to.
He's trying to chase Mike. He want to chase Mike and Kobe. You know that's what he want to do to me if you ask me. Which is it's not gonna happen that he gonna catch Mike. I don't see it happening. You know, so I think that's what they're trying to do. You know, not they, but I think it's LeBron under. Handed and thinking of doing that, he want to catch Mike and Kobe so bad that he's willing to do anything it takes. Damn what the fans think about him and what they say. Oh, it's working. All right, we got the phone lines up working now. Back in order here. Back in order. But all right, Longhorn, give us some of that Black History Month here before we move on to some NFL talk. And go by the way, my North Carolina Tar Heels, how they doing, Longhorn?
How they doing?
Yeah,
they doing all right?
All right.
They're holding their own. Yeah. But like I said earlier, tell us your second and third choice.
3-1-3. Ain't gonna my second choice.
tournament.
It ain't gonna happen. 3-1-3.
Because I know you got a second and third.
No, we don't play that down in Tar Heel country. 3-1-3.
Oh, Lord.
313-868-4336. 313-868-0351 or 0352. Give them some of that Black History Moments, Longhorn.
All right, Black History Moments. Black History Moments. The tricycle. The tricycle was invented in 1886 by Matthew A. Cherry. So you got a tricycle in your garage and your little kid riding around on a tricycle? You can credit that to Matthew A. Cherry in 1886. Also, the thermostat control. You know how people going around and saying, hey, it's too hot in here, it's too cold in here. Who changed the who been messing around with the thermostat? Well, in 1960, Frederick M. Jones invented the thermostat control. The phone transmitter. Without the phone transmitter, we probably wouldn't have these cell phone deals we got here. And no, this is not an iPhone. This is an old school phone right here. I don't have the latest and the greatest. You know, I can't afford that high-speed stuff. But anyway, in 1884, Granville T. Woods invented the phone transmitter. All right. We're going to go all the way back to the, everybody know Madam C.J. Walker invented the straightening comb in 1905. You know, get your hair all straight, you know, so you can throw it to the left, to the right. In my case, I sport a bald head, so, you know, I don't throw nothing to the left, to the right. All my curls, I went to the inside. And last but not least.
Looked like they all went under that damn hat you got on. That's what it looked like.
last but not least, the record player arm. So you get your jiggy on, so you get your Wayne Dane doodle. All right, the record player arm was invented in 1819 by Joseph H. Dickinson. That's right. Joseph H. Dickinson invented the record player arm. So you can get out there, get your Wayne Dane doodle on, and have a good time in the house tonight.
Who invented it?
So that is the Black History Moment.
Let me tell you something, Grinch. Who invented the Easter basket?
Oh, somebody who want to get paid off of Easter? Somebody who want to get paid off of Easter invented the Easter basket and put all that stuff in there so y'all go out there and pay for it? Want a real Easter basket? Just get your plastic bag.
Who invented
out there and put your eggs in a plastic bag.
Longhorn, who invented
that? Better yet, just get you a sack. Longhorn. Anybody know what a sack is?
Hey, Longhorn, why you all mad? Who invented the colored eggs?
Oh, somebody who wanted to get paid, like I said, off of you going out there and coloring the egg.
How about
just so they can be picked apart, and you don't even eat the coloring part, just pick it apart.
How about the grass?
Somebody want to get paid. I wish I'd invented the color and dye for about, eggs. I got paid off that, too.
One more, Longhorn. Who invented
it? Yeah.
Who invented the grass to go in the Easter basket? I ain't talking about the grass that you used to smoke either.
Oh, you talking about that fake grass? that fake plastic grass? Who invented the thing they call the Easter bunny? Oh, let me tell you real fast while we're talking about Easter. I heard a commercial on the other day when I was riding, and this guy said, parents, beware about buying your kids little Easter chickens, little chicks, and little Easter bunnies, little baby bunnies, because they will get big in time. And I said to myself, really? Really? Is that the commercial you're trying to tell the folks?
Hey, well, but I'm telling you something, Longhorn, all kidding aside, I done that with Chris. When my youngest daughter went down to Eastern Market, bought her a bunny. Bunny was small as hell. Time I got through feeding, that was my fault though. You know, I kept overfeeding the bunny, man. That bunny was so damn big, we can damn near ride that bunny.
But the kicker part about that commercial was that the guy in the commercial was warning the parents about buying baby chicks and baby bunnies for your kids on Easter because eventually they will get bigger. And I'm saying to myself, if you're a grown person and you don't know a chick turning into a chicken, and a baby bunny turns into a bigger bunny, then there's something wrong with you.
All right, Longhorn.
You need to be feeding that chick so you can, as he get bigger, he turns into some drum legs and a chicken breast on your table, and that bunny turns into a bunny in your pot, then that's how I look at it.
And that's the Longhorn monologue on killing every kid's dream today on having a happy Easter. Longhorn, let's jump on some NFL.
On that grill.
Let's do some NFL real fast, Longhorn. A couple of things. The Broncos.
Lions going to play in China.
Hell, they can't even play in Detroit. What the hell they going to China for?
Hey, I was doing some research, man, and they trying to get the Lions to play.
And then they learn from going over to England last year, getting whooped by Kansas City. Why would
the NFL is trying to open up the China market to the NFL.
Yeah, okay.
So they trying to
just make them a laughing stock all over the world, huh? Man, don't stop in England. It's just going over there to China too, huh? Yeah, okay. We'll just be the laughing stock everywhere. But check this out. Speaking of laughing stock, let's talk about RG3 joining Cleveland Browns and also the Browns fans, which I thought this was, I don't know if they on dope or dog food in Cleveland, but they picked Johnny Manziel over Jim Brown as the greatest Brown player ever to play for their team. Your thoughts on those two, Longhorn? First, you can start with RG3.
Well, RG3 going to Cleveland Browns. At least we know he's going to start.
Yeah, the 25th quarterback starting since 99. Yeah.
They say that's where quarterbacks go to the quarterback graveyard over there. They say that's the quarterback cemetery at the Browns. So I say, well, yeah, we got to see how it works out.
Yeah, I don't think they know, you know, right now what's going on. You know, so hit and miss types. I think what RG3 going to have to do is change up his game.
Right.
And become a pocket passer. The running game is a wrap for him. That's secondary now. RG3, you can't just run first and throw. It's not going to work. You know, your legs and your knees ain't like they used to be. You're not at Baylor no more. Change up your game. They got video on you. So become a pocket passer, and you'll have a long career in the NFL here. You know,
I think RG is going to have to become more of a, like you say, a pocket passer and a scrambler in the backfield.
Exactly.
I think his scrambling ability, if he can scramble and juke players out, And you know how you like they point downfield and his receivers see that he's in trouble and get in open for him, and he can throw it down, launch it downfield. He'll be a success.
Okay, well,
like you say, pocket passes, scrambling, and then the third option is the run.
I'm wishing the best for him. I hope he have a bounce back career and do his thing and everything work out for him in Cleveland and show all them haters and doubters, especially in Washington, that y'all made a big mistake by getting rid of it. But sometimes it's a good thing. You know, sometimes change is good. You know, look how it worked out for you in Texas leaving Detroit, Longhorn. Did change good?
I'm down here. I'm coming back to Detroit.
Yeah, all right, let's get to our big dummy real fast, Longhorn, because we only got a few minutes left in the show.
For those Cleveland fans who think that Manziel is better than the Jim Brown,
yeah,
they must be on something. I don't know what it is, but they're on something. And for that, I think they need straight jackets.
Let's get to our big dummies.
All right.
All right, Longhorn, who's your big dummy for the week?
My big dummy. I was watching a court TV show, you know, where they sue people, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this sister was suing this store owner for $1,000 because the store owner had this little flyer said, if you buy these heels that I'm selling, you're guaranteed to get a husband. But underneath the guarantee, she had wink, wink. So this sister is trying to sue. She bought these shoes. Then she put on her shortest dress. She walking down the street in her shortest dress. going to the club. She didn't get no husband. So now she on the court show trying to sue the lady who owned the boutique for $1,000 because she didn't get no husband.
Did she get the
talking about it was guaranteed on the flyer. And the judge said, did you see this big old wink, wink at the bottom? She said, yeah, I saw it. But it says guaranteed on top of that I was guaranteed to get a husband. You talking about a big dummy.
But did she get
the big? You talking about a big dummy.
But did she get the big Bobowski though that night?
She didn't get it. The judge said, when last time you had a man? Oh, and supposedly the lady suing, the sister suing, yeah, had a master's degree in science and was a school teacher.
Oh, hell no.
Yeah, big dummy right there, boy.
All right. My big dummy for the week has to be the Cleveland Browns fans. You must be total idiots if you think Johnny Manziel is better than Jim Brown. I didn't see the whole list. I might have to pull up that list, Longhorn, but let's just talk Jim Brown alone. This guy sucks as a quarterback. If he was better than Jim Brown. Johnny Manziel sucks as a quarterback. Jim Brown has gone down as one of the greatest running backs in history. And if Johnny Manziel was such a great player, then Jim Brown, guess what? He'll still be with Cleveland. He's with no NFL team right now, not one. You know, he went out and got him that high-priced agent, Drew Rosenhaus or whatever his name is, talking about there's teams out there interested in him. Who, Drew? Who over in the CFL, the Powell
Football League,
the Powell League? Ain't I mean
the
I don't.
Powell League.
I mean, there's executives NFL executive that said he's been as one of the second worst draft picks ever. So my big dummy goes out to the Cleveland Browns fan for picking Johnny Manziel over Jim Brown alone.
Big dummy.
All right, Longhorn, give me some of your shout-outs, your last final thoughts before we get out of here until next week.
My final shout-out is stay motivated, dedicated to your cause. Stay looking forward. Keep your eyes on the prize. Game time, prime time. Detroit Sports Jersey Media time. The Longhorn is gone to next week. Next Sunday,
11 a.m. We right here live, 107.3 in the D. And join us, you know, every Sunday. And all I got to say to Longhorn and everybody else, here comes Peter Cottontail hopping down the bunny trail. Happy Easter week. We out of here until next week.
Thank you, listeners from Detroit, Texas, and the Virgin Islands, for joining us here live on Detroit Sports Jersey Media with your host, Will, and co-host, Longhorn. Every Sunday at 11 a.m. Eastern, right here on 107.3 FM WVIE. Visit us at DetroitSportsJersey.com. Straight sports talk, no professionals here. Have a great week.